Okay, we are still on the part of our lawmaking process. So, we have seen a bill, we have seen the process in the House of Representatives, to which the same process is repeated on the Senate. Now we are moving on to the third stage. Okay, the third stage, which is the royal assent, eh? Okay, royal assent. So basically, once Senate has approved, so when the bill has been passed by both houses, okay, it'll be presented to the Yang di-Pertuan Agong for his assent or for his express approval. So basically, Article 66, Clause 4 of the Federal Constitution, as amended by the Constitution Amendment Act 1994. So Yang di-Pertuan Agong shall within 30 days after being presented to him, so he should give assent or express approval to the bill. So thereby after that a public seal will be affixed to the bill. Now if he's not done within 30 days of the bill of from the date the bill was presented, so the bill will become law at the expiration of the 30-day period, as if the Yang di-Pertuan Agong has assented to it. So basically, Yang di-Pertuan Agong should give his royal assent. Otherwise, if the 30 days has lapsed, it's actually automatically become a law. So from bill will become an act. So this is it's important for the you to know this is the third process. Now, for the next process after getting royal assent, okay. When the bill automatically become an act, it does not automatically coming into force. Okay, no act shall become into shall come into force until it's being published, or what we normally say in Bahasa Malaysia diwartakan, or another word of saying is being gazetted. However, subject to the Parliament to give an act retrospective effect. Meaning, if it's retrospective effect, let's say we get the royal assent on the 1st of January 2020. If the Parliament has given a retrospective effect, meaning to say that the act can actually take effects on December 2019. That is retrospective effect, meaning it goes backward on the enforcement date. So publication is normally done in the Warta Kerajaan or what we call Federal Gazette. Let me show you how does a Gazette looks like. Okay, this is how Warta Kerajaan looks like. Warta Kerajaan Seri Paduka Baginda diterbitkan dengan kuasa. So, His Majesty's Government Gazette published by authority. This is Jilid 61 on the 9th of March 2017, number 10. So, this is basically in English and in Malay, both in English and Malay. So, these are the warta. Okay, Warta Kerajaan. Okay. So Gazette notification number 716 dated 30 January is repeal, meaning they repeal the earlier Gazette notification. So this is Warta Kerajaan. There's another part of Warta Kerajaan, but reproduce by no, this is the real Warta Kerajaan. But if you happen to download from the website, this is what you're going to see. People thought that these are the real Warta Kerajaan, but this the other one is actually published, not published, but has been made known, publicized by the AG Chambers. Let me just show you how does it look like. This is the real Warta Kerajaan. Okay, this is what normally people, you know, when you download from the website, you're going to see this sort of Warta Kerajaan. What we see just now was this Warta Kerajaan, but this is the real Warta Kerajaan. But of late, you can see this, okay, and it has been published by the Jabatan Peguam Negara. So if you want to actually look at all the wata kerajaan, I suggest you to go to the Parliament website where you can download a lot of documents from there. Sorry, wata kerajaan can be downloaded from the Federal Gazette. You can look for website Federal Gazette of Government Malaysia, and for Parliament, you can only download handset documents. Okay, have a look at all these websites. They give you a very good idea of how does proper bills looks like, and the wata kerajaan has been published before. So I suggest you take some time and have a look at all these publications. So we have looked through the third types of written law. So next, we're going to move on to subsidiary legislation. Okay.